Hello everyone, welcome to Education Lecture. In this video, I'll be teaching you the 11th lesson, that is Japan and Brazil through a traveler's eye written by George Mikes. If you are new to my channel, then subscribe my channel to get further new updates. And as I told in my previous videos, they won't ask any questions regarding the author or the poet. It is same with this lesson also. So I'll be telling you the summary of this lesson. So let's get started. Before the lesson starts, they have given you a note on travel writing. I will say in a short, travel writing is they explore new places, and when they explore new places, about that place they write. So when they travel at this time to explore a place, that they write it. They just note down or write into storybooks, anything. That is called travel writing. So this one they won't ask you in your exams at all. It is just for your information what is travel writing. So they have written that from many centuries travel writing is there. Till now travel writing has been followed, more than the world has been explored, many places in the world has been explored, but still people are eager to explore more places with their more interest and enthusiasm. They want to explore more places, so still travel writing is going on. For example, if you are traveling and suddenly you see a place with different custom traditions and the people's behavior over there, so and you find a new place like somewhat an island, you think, so you go there, you visit there and you write what are the things available, what are the behavior of the people living over there. So that you travel and you write what are the things happening in that island. For example, it is. So this is travel writing, but still now travel writing is there, and travel writing some are in books, some now we see on our televisions and on internet we do researches, right? So like that also travel writing is there. It is not vanished yet, still it is there. The enthusiasm of people and eagerness of people to know about different places is still going on. So I'll be telling you the meanings which are unknown to you. So genre means different styles in art and literature. Then patronage means support, commissioned, instructed or commanded, seized, come or bring to an end. Next is narratives, is accounts or description. I told her they would write a book on it. Subtly, uphold means fine, support. So here in this lesson also, a traveler visits to Japan and Brazil, and he tells there what are the customs and traditions and what are the behavior of the people living over there. So Japanese manners. So he goes quarter an hour in Japan and he sees there people are so beautifully well mannered. So quarter is 15 minutes as we know, and exquisitely means, if I am wrong, please forgive me, beautifully. So the people over there are very beautifully well mannered, and here the population is overcrowded in Japan. That is hopelessly means, don't think that is hopeless. Hopelessly means here in this lesson is population. Overcrowded island is Japan. So here they respect one another's privacy. They respect each other. So courtesy has a double function. So here courtesy has a double function. They will ask you this question, which has a double function, or what does courtesy have a double function? Say, what is that? Just in a random I am saying, they will ask you a question about this. So the courtesy has a double function. Courtesy means polite behavior or polite speech. So it is courtesy. And it substitute privacy. So thing, acting or serving in a piece of another. Privacy is a state in which one is not disturbed by other people. So each other respect each other. They are very polite in behavior and they do not disturb each other whatever work they are doing. So courtesy has a substitute privacy. So here the traveler tells an example that there is a little red telephones in streets, shops, halls of hotels. they don't have a lot of place to keep a booth. Booth, you could have seen, right? There would be a separate box in which the telephones would be kept. A person would go inside the booth and speak. But here, there is a overcrowded population in this place. So, there is no place to keep the booths. So, they have kept in streets. Means, while going on streets, you might have seen small shops. In shops, they would have kept. Or in hotels, in halls, they would have kept this booths. But this telephone is a man's castle. They'll ask you, what is a telephone receiver for a man? It is a castle, that is a palace. So it is a castle. Why? Because is here people would talk right in front of everyone, streets, because it is overcrowded. Many people across you and go think a man is talking in a telephone booth, and many people go near him and think to their works. But none of them listens whatever he speaks, whether it may be the business transactions or your intimate love quarrels, whatever about business or any financial things or your love quarrels, in a public, yet in a perfect privacy. So no one is there to disturb the man over here. So he has a privacy. So the telephone receiver is this castle. So they will ask you, which is the man's castle? It is a telephone receiver. So no one would take trouble to listen to other speech. They would be on their job. So the man or the woman, anybody can speak to the other person in telephone freely. So this is about the first para. Second para, so he notices that the mania, the obsession, addicted of Boeing. So in Japan, you might have seen in many films that they keep, when they see a person in front of them coming towards him, they bow. Or any of them visiting their homes, they bow. So here, everyone keeps bowing to everybody else. So with the ceremonies, that is grand, formal. Formal bow. Solemnity, very seriously. Of a courtier, king's advisor, like king, they bow to each other with a very formal manner. So with a great deal of natural and inimitable, which cannot be copied. So each person may have a different way of bowing, right? So that cannot be copied. Grace, elegance. So bowing is neither less nor more silly than shaking hands or kissing the cheek. So bowing is not that easy. Also, not that hard also, like many people shake hands or kiss each other's cheeks and hug each other while they meet, when they meet each other. So, here also they do the same, like same shaking the hands, hugging them, each other, kissing the cheek. Don't write hugging, they have given only kissing the cheek here. Okay, but it is an quanter, old-fashioned, unusual or strange custom, more formal, more oriental custom, which belong to the east or opposite of that is west. So the eastern part, the custom comes from there. From there it has spread to all over the Japan. They bow to each other. It is also infectious, spreading all over. So when the traveler went to Japan and he sees everyone keep bowing to each other, it is like an infection. It is really not an infection, means suddenly a person comes, bows and goes. If you see another person, he comes, bows, even the other person also bows to him. And soon even the traveler also feels like bowing to others. So after a few hours, you start bowing to yourself. So when you also visit, you will also, by seeing all these people bowing to each other, you also start bowing. So you bow too deeply or not too deeply enough, or you bow to the wrong man at the wrong time. You do not clasp your hand in front of you, which is bad, or you do, which is worse. So we people, when we visit Japan for the first time, we would not know right what is the correct manner of bowing. So sometimes we may bow very deep, sometimes we may not bow properly, we won't clasp our hands. If you want more in detail, you can see in your Google, just the photos if you see, or you can see here only. See, the man is bowing, clasped his hand in front of them. So, if we go there, we people don't know right how to do in a correct manner. So we do it worse also. So you will discover that the Japanese have a complicated hierarchy that is very difficult to understand, or a complicated, very difficult hierarchy, a system in which members of an organization or society are ranked according to relative status or authority in Boeing. Who bows to whom, how deeply and how long. One of the American, so wait, I'll say here. So he says, I am a sales manager and more than me, a higher post man is there. So when he comes, I bow little deeply because he is in a higher post. He bows little, not too deeply. So there is an a system in which they see the rank of a person. If he is a little lower post, he should bend little deep than the other person. So according to that, or the status, if he is rich, he is a middle class, or a poor, according to that, or the authority, whatever he has, if he is a somewhat in a higher position, he has to be given such a bowing. So these are the things. Okay, so the traveler says in American states also it is like that. Only early in a traffic law was there that when two cars come in front of each other intersection, two roads which meet each other, before the other person goes, now think a car is there, this is a car and these both come at the intersection. So when he tries to go, he can go only when this car is moved. So after he goes only, he can come. So that was the traffic law. These and all they want us just for the information he is telling. So this was before the other had gone. Okay. So this was laid before in earlier days in American states. So now he is saying, if two Japanese bow, neither is to straighten up before the other stands erect in front of him. So he also says that it is same with these Japanese people also. They say the status, rank of a person, right? So before the other person stands straight, we have to straighten up the other person stands erect in front of him. So after if the higher position manager is standing in front of you, after he straightens up himself only, stand straightly in front of him. So according to the position rank, as I told, now I don't want to go very deeply, it will extend the video. So it is very complicated for us, okay? So when we go newly to Japan, it is very complicated, but the people over there do without any difficulty. With the smallest difference in rank, standing position, standing is position, age, social position, which is subtly reflected in that split second. The split second, they would, in that correct second, when the higher position manager stands erect, after the next second, we stand, the lower position one. So, this small difference also, they do it very perfectly, he says. Okay, next, so here, one man's bow is shorter than the others. In many cases, there is a clear-cut difference in the position. So, now it comes to the family. Basic rules inside a family. So, wife bows to her husband, the child bows to his father, younger brothers to elder ones, the sister bows to all brothers, whether it's a small younger one or whatever age. So he traveler sees a small baby carried in Japanese style on their mother back. That is here the baby is being carried back of the mother. So in the Japanese style, they have been he has been carried, that child, when the mother bows, right? When the mother bows, even the child, we feel like even the child is bowing in front of us from that great height. The child carried in their mother's back, when she bends, he is also bowing from such a height, majestic height. So condescending means to bend. Okay, so here even in stores also they employ bowing girls. the girls who go to the people, the customers who are coming to their shop. The similarly, even they appoint the Boeing boys also. So these girls will be standing on top of the escalator. Differentially, respectfully, they bow deeply. All and sundry is they'll give in fill in the blanks. Different kinds of people, whatever age, whatever position, whatever he may be ranked in status, whatever, they bow deeply. Same equivalent to the girls who are employed, even boys are employed in the turning revolving doors. The doors, front of the shop, the doors will be there, right? When you enter, there they are employed. So here, these are the Boeing things. Next, here until here, Boeing one comes. The Tokaido line. So when he goes to the railway station, the Tokaido line between Tokyo and Osaka. So in this line, when going in a train from Tokyo to Osaka, Tokyo and Osaka, here two conductors come to enter the carriage with a very theoretical scene. Like a very strict officers they come, and they come at the middle of the coach and bow very formally, that is ceremoniously formally in both directions, and start checking the tickets. Then the traveler goes to a park. Nara is a park in Japan. So he meets a deer. So he takes for him food, the deer's food, right? He takes that and goes. When he sees the deer, he sees that the deer bowed deeply to him. Because seeing everyone bowing, he told, right, it is very infectious. Even we get an habit of it. So he also says, even the deer bowed deeply to me. Traveler is saying, he is also saying, how can a deer bow? He is thinking, okay, I think so. It may be imitative, that is, it is imitating the other's actions. Then he thinks that also, that all time seeing people bowing to each other, he is also getting a habit of it. And another also, I think it is a Japanese deer. I think in it is gene, it is having that bowing thing one. But it bowed very courteously, very formally, proper manner the deer bowed. So genetic means hereditary. It is in a gene of the deer. So while seeing and thinking about that, he did not notice that the deer came in front of him, jumped at him and snatched the food bag. The food bag he brought for deer, right? He took from it. But still now he cannot know the deer really bored. It really bored. I don't know why, what. He really got confused about that. So in this too, the deer was a true Japanese. Now he comes to the, he tells about the bus stop. Every people will be bowing in bus stop seeing other peoples. When the bus arrives, all these gentle people turn into savages. When the bus arrives, right, they rush into the bus. They push aside, they push the people. They stamp on the toes. Then they, in their elbows, you know, right, in the hand elbows, they just push into other's stomach. Somewhat very horribly, they go inside the bus. They rush when the bus arrives. But before the bus, in the bus stop, they were very peaceable people. After the bus arrived, they become savages. So this is about the bowing thing. Next, the eating soup in Japan. So when he is eating soup in Japan, he says that we have to make a fearful noise. A fearful noise because the host there will think that, oh, he is loving our soup. He likes the taste of the soup. Very good. But it is very danger, means not eating soup. Eating soup with together, we are making noise, right? It is very danger because when we people go newly there, if we make such a noise, they will think what an ill-mannered lout, that is very rude person in behavior. They think that if you don't make the noise also, they will say what an ill-mannered lout. So both has a problem here. If you make noise, if you don't make noise also. So this is about Japan, the traveler says. Next, about Brazil. So he says nobody hurries in Brazil, whether they reach soon or whether they reach 1 hour, 2 hour late, or whether they don't reach to their destination at all. they are very calm kind of, they won't do anything. And here, right, the gray pavements, they will ask you, the gray pavements in Copacabana are decorated with dash. So black mosaics, pavements is footpath, they are decorated very beautifully. So other person says, traveler says, who will take such a risk to decorate these pavements? All the people will walk and go, but who are very meditative, ambulatory, walking exercise, would take the trouble to decorate the pavements. So who will do the walking, eating, right, there in the path pavements? So they would take an interest and do this decorative things and all. So contemplation, to think very deeply, how can it be decorated? So this is about the mosaics, the pavements in Brazil and the peoples over there. Now, however, as soon as they easily going leisurely characters change into, when they get a steering wheel, that a car will have a steering wheel, right? When they get that steering wheel, no speed is fast enough. The speed, right, the speedometer will also increase, it will go to a max because of their speed. When once these pleasant people get the steering wheel, you may not know, they will go so fastly in their cars. Here they have told they are very pleasant, they, whether they reach or not to the destination, they don't care. But here, once the person gets the steering wheel, the 10th of the second is a matter of grave, serious importance for all of them, all the time. So such a speed they go at a second. So in a minute, they raise their speed. So motor cars in Brazil are very expensive. They are imported. Import duties means product or a service produced in abroad, that is other countries, that is purchased in your home country. If you are staying here and the cars are coming from other countries, then we are purchasing from that country. So that time they will increase the money and they will raise the price and tell to us, right, while we are purchasing. So it is very very expensive over here. So it is weakened and murderous. This is crippling means weakened, murderous means kill or cruel or But still, people buy your cars as if the cars were distributed for free of cost. Like cars were given to freely, freely. It is expensive, but still whatever status he may be, everybody has cars here. So leaps and bounds, it is increasing, but it is increasing. So here, see, they have written, see, were distributed free of charge to all and sundry. That is different kinds of people. Okay. Thus the pedestrians, people walking on road, life is becoming more hazardous, that is dangerous every day. So now they have got the steering wheel. So the people who are walking on the pavements, right, their lives have been risked. Why the lives have been risked? Like, now when the pedestrian wants to cross the road from this pavement to that pavement, from this end to this end, when he keeps his leg on the road, where the driver of the car will come only, we don't know. Suddenly he will full speed, he will come. Just for a simple manner I'm saying, he raises his speed and comes towards the pedestrian as he is going to do an accident to him. The pedestrian runs for his life. Ayo, he is coming. What to do? He will also run for his life. As he steps on the footpath, no danger for him. So they have given that only. If you read this parallel, see, as soon as the driver notices a pedestrian step off the pavement, he regards him as a fair game competition. He takes aim and accelerates. The pedestrian has to jump, leap and run for dear life. He does not resent this in the least. Driver and pedestrian, hunter and prey, like a hunter, like a lion is chasing a prey, that is a rabbit or deer or something like that. The driver is the hunter, the prey is the pedestrian. Smile amicably, friendly to each other. I win today, you will win tomorrow, fair enough. So Like they chase like this also, but still there is no animism. They smile, the pedestrian will smile at the driver. They were like very friendly manner. Today I will win, like chasing, I have won. Tomorrow you will win. So fair enough. So now even the war between the drivers, right, is murderous. One will come both the sides. They will overtake each other like in a second, 20 times every hour. This bus is going from, as if they are going to make an accident. Such a heinous means wicked crimes. Somewhat like stupidness, they do the crimes there. So the traveler thinks like that. So there is no anger, no hostility, unfriendliness, no mad hooting to cry out or shout. But still, these also, they smile at each other, no problem. Just for the fun they are having. So, the Avenida Presidente Vargas is the worst place of all. Here, the traffic is so huge that slowly... See, how can a crawling traffic proceed at such a terrifying speed? So, these people having a steering wheel in hand, they will increase their they will accelerate for sure, but the traffic is so so much that they can't go for their speed. They can just move an inch by inch. That is a crawling traffic. Okay, so after an hour passes, hour after, without an hope, an auspicious favorable crossing, a scene will happen. Well, that is a man is standing in one side in the Avenida Presidente Vargas. Okay, he reaches on the other side. So beside him was standing, right, his friend. How did he go there in this crawling traffic? How did he cross the road and go to the other side of the footpath? So he will be thinking, so he will shout. The traffic, the horn sound, everything will be going right. Beyond that, he will shout with all the mystified, confused. So the man is confused, no? He says, how on earth did you get over there? He shouts across, trying to make himself heard above the traffic. So the other man who had crossed the, who had gone to the other side says, he says, what? This man is asking like somewhat stupid question. Okay, he feels like that. So he says, how I was born on this side? So a name is innocent, simple question. Yeah, so he says, how I was born on this side. So I was on this side, and he says. So here, these excrements are chosen from the land of the rising yen is Japan, and how to tango is Brazil. These are passages extracted. So this and alone it, right? Until here is the lesson. So that's all is the lesson. I'll be showing you the one mark questions which are often repeated in your exams. I hope you can see. Yeah. If you want to just take a note of it, you can write. Or you can just read it from here. These are the major points and the main points which I told in the summary, right? This question, that question will come. So those only I have written. Once before you go to your exam hall, if you see this question and answers, you just, it will recall your story. You can pause the video and see, or anyhow, whichever is comfortable to you can do. So if you have understood or didn't understand anything, or you have any problem with my teaching, you can comment in the comment box, so that it will help me in doing my it will encourage me in doing my further videos. So as I told, if you know, once this story is more than enough to write your brief answers. So these are the brief answer questions which are repeated, and with the last page. So these are, if you once know this story, is more than enough to write your brief answers. So like, share, comment and subscribe. to my channel to get further more updates. Thank you.